Now in this part, assuming that we have good counting statistics and we have counted the source for a decent amount of time and we are able to clearly see the peaks. Press in here and it should clear up a little bit. Okay. Okay. Then we can go in there and we go into the bars in here. You can select toggle between KEV and channels if you want to see full channel 16,000 versus KEV. And then you can go into the scale in here to zoom on, to zoom out. You can hit the cursor here. And once you're in the cursor spec, you can toggle between spectrum and cursor mode. Once you're in the spectrum mode, then you do have a cursor in here that you can select any zone of the spectrum in here. But you cannot actually read the peak counts in here from here. You have to do it from the software, but you can see it in the info. And then if you look at the info, and if you look at the peaks, it's telling me that it's found the cobalt 60 peak, the second peak in here. You can also hit the alternate, and you have some other information that gives you the area, full width, half maximum, tenth maximum counts, and then it identifies the nuclide, which in our case was cobalt 60. Back, what else? Now you can go to the calibration menu in here. You can apply the calibration from a spectrum, which is much better to do. We suggest that the real calibration of the system should be done from a nice spectrum and from the software and transferred from the device here. But if you want to apply the calibration, I have several spectrums that I have acquired, and I can load something from the file and apply it. So I can go in here, I can load. I see that we have a test November 17th calibration spectrum, which is one I like. We can load it, and then we can go into calibration and we can apply it to the MCA. So you can also calibrate the MCA by applying a spectrum, or you can do a live calibration. In order to do a live calibration, you will have to acquire a spectrum, and then you can do a two peak calibration or a single peak calibration. And for the sake of time, what I have done in here, if you go to that, I have actually gone into the training videos in here, and I have saved under Hawk Electric actually a full video done by one of our engineers, Daniel, who spent a lot of time.
After finish the calibration time.
How to do the calibration and please see this video, because it's about 5 minutes.
We like the calibration.
And it shows you how to do the calibration right there on the screen.
And we see here, calibrate. Just push this one. And we like to use two peaks in here, cesium and cobalt, okay? And then it will tell us the first, we have to do the select peak number one. So move your cursor to the cesium peak, it is number, peak number one. If you need, then you can zoom in these peaks, so you can see like this. Then you can move your cursor close to the peak here, and then after this double arrow, the right side, you click, and then the second you have to set left bound of peak number one. Just move your peak here to the left side of the peaks, and then push this second arrow, and move your cursor until the right one.
Region of interest.
And then again push this to confirm, and then you have to put your energy, the energy of these peaks. 11.6661.6. Okay. Then confirm. You have to confirm. Then the number 5 is select peak number 2. In this case, we like to select the second peak of the cobalt. Again, is zoom with the scale plus closer to the peak. See, this is spectrum and then cursor. You can move right to or left. Then push these arrows, and he likes us to put the left RY. Bring this to the right. Okay, then confirm. You have to input the energy calibration 1332.5, and then okay. Then you have to reconfirm. Finish. Then energy calibration. This equation is directly here, and then we apply to this display.
Display architecture.
Yeah, to the detector.